these three individual pigments can be combined to create various shades of brown.
This is Kelly Dobos.
I've been formulating products for over 20 years. I've worked for Bonnie Bell, Jergens Lotion, and Purell. Color cosmetics is one of my specialties.
And now she teaches cosmetic science at the University of Cincinnati. So
today we're gonna break down the ingredients in Ilia's True Skin Serum Foundation. Aloe leaf juice.
There are over 35 ingredients listed on this $54 foundation.
Polyresinoli.
But let's start with pigments. That's where those iron oxides come in. Ilia did not respond to the Wall Street Journal's request for comments on any of its ingredients, but Kelly says those iron oxides are key here.
In foundations, we use four primary pigments, which are red iron oxide, yellow iron oxide, and black iron oxide, as well as titanium dioxide to tint the foundation. Iron oxides are exactly like they sound. They're basically rust. Red iron oxide, of course, is probably most familiar. Titanium dioxide is used to tint the foundation to different shades, but it's also added to increase opacity. The higher coverage of a foundation, the higher level of titanium dioxide. See how it turns into brown when you mix them all together?
All of these ingredients are considered safe by the FDA. However, titanium dioxide, which is in many foundations and sunscreens, has recently come under scrutiny.
Titanium dioxide can be a carcinogen by inhalation.
California's Prop 65 requires businesses to warn consumers about titanium dioxide when it is in the form of airborne particles, not in these liquid foundations.
What we know about titanium dioxide is that it is safe when used in cosmetic formulations. The concern really comes from industrial exposures to workers who might be in manufacturing situations.
Iron oxides have a moderate safety score, according to the Environmental Working Group's database on personal care product ingredients. They're found in over 7,000 foundations.
The iron oxides are a very smooth feeling. We don't want them to settle where you would have to shake your foundation every time you want to use it.
In order to prevent the oxides from settling in the foundation, chemists will dissolve the pigments in a liquid that has yield value, something like this ingredient.
Yield value is the ability to suspend a particle. Hand sanitizer contains a polymer that provides yield value. You can see that it is suspended in the solution. Another aspect of foundations is, of course, the main solvent. Water is the best known solvent to most of us. It's a very low cost ingredient. The Ilia Foundation, however, uses aloe leaf juice instead of water, which has to be harvested and processed in order to use in cosmetic products. So that adds a significant cost to the formulation. Aloe is about 98% water, making it a good substitute for water.
Another underestimated ingredient.
I think fillers often get a bad rap. They sound like they're not doing much in a formulation, but they're really important to balancing the feel of a product across the entire range of shades.
Fillers help the pigments in the foundation spread evenly. Kelly says other makeup brands have used talc as a filler.
The talc used in cosmetics is highly refined to remove any traces of contaminants. However, there have been some controversies where talc has been contaminated with asbestos, and that has caused it to be removed from many products.
The FDA says it continues to test for contamination in cosmetics containing talc. Ilia does not use talc. Its ingredients list rice hull powder and boron nitride.
Boron nitride and rice powder are more expensive than talc, and they have additional properties like the boron nitride provides the optical blurring.
This optical blurring from the boron nitride helps create an overall smoothness in the face.
So this line represents the particle of boron nitride. We have incoming light hitting the particle, and it can be reflected at the same angle, or it can be reflected at many different angles, and that's what the optical blurring effect is.
There are also skincare ingredients on the list.
As cosmetic chemists, we have three different strategies for moisturizing the skin. Those are using humectants, emollients, or occlusives in a formulation. A humectant helps absorb water like a sponge. And an emollient or an occlusive forms a protective layer over the skin like this wax paper. If we look at the label for the Ilia Foundation, we have hydrating ingredients. We also have emollients. Glycerin is extremely effective at hydrating the skin. And it's also very cost effective. And it feels pretty sticky to the touch as well.
The order of ingredients matters.
Cosmetic ingredients are listed in descending order of predominance. That means the greatest concentration of ingredients are closer to the top of the list. The Ilia Foundation contains ingredients like niacinamide, allantoin, and bisabolol. These are bringing benefits to the foundation like skin tone evening and additional hydration. The ingredients with skincare benefits are closer to the middle of the list in this formula, indicating to me that they are at efficacious levels.
And much like lotion,
foundations are typically emulsion products. That means we're combining oil and water or silicone phases. In the Ilia Foundation, we have polyglycerol 2 isostearate as an emulsifier. Hydrogenated lecithin can also be used as an emulsifier.
And an ordinary ingredient also helps.
You might be wondering why sodium chloride, ordinary table salt, is in this foundation. Well, it's really doing a pretty important job. It helps stabilize the particles in the emulsion so that they don't coalesce into larger droplets and destabilize the formula, but it also helps lower the freezing point so that the material is more stable when it's transported.
Once the foundation lands on your shelf, preservatives are responsible for keeping the product safe from bacteria.
Different preservatives are efficacious against different types of organisms. We have yeast and molds, bacteria, so we often have to use multiple to achieve broad spectrum protection. Each time you dip your finger into your product, you're basically adding bacteria to it. And as cosmetic chemists, we do studies to simulate that. We call that a preservative challenge test.
There are other things to note on the overall packaging.
Ilia markets itself as a clean beauty brand. Clean beauty is not defined in a regulatory sense in the cosmetics industry, so many retailers and brands have come up with their own definitions of clean beauty, and it tends to focus on more naturally derived ingredients, as well as ingredients with known safety profiles.
Cosmetics are not required to have FDA approval before going to market, but the FDA does provide guidance when it comes to product safety.
Safety first. I always bring up safety, lab safety. Especially when I see a picture somewhere of a scientist and they're like staring at a beaker. And I'm also like, nobody stares at a beaker up in the air. You put it on the table.